Name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Welcome to St. Paul's Servant Preparation Course. Today we're going to have the second talk about the dogma. We're going to talk about the proofs of God's existence. So let's get started. Dogma Part 2. Proofs of God's existence. Objective: to prove that God exists via different methods, including astrology, science, living creature, divine revelation, power over evil, control of the world, and biblical proofs. Proofs of God's existence, astrology, science, living creature, divine revelation, control the evil, control the world, and biblical proofs. First, we'll start by astrology. Why should there be a God? First of all, the universe is well-formed and functional with great precision and accuracy. There are millions and millions of galaxies with numerous stars orbiting planets with absolute precision and accuracy. The solar system is one example. When the planet orbits the sun and the moons orbit the planet, the creatures on the earth have life, feeling, emotion, conscious, moral, and so on. If you look at the solar system, all these planets orbit the sun in very controlled manner. They don't touch one another, and they have moons orbit around them. And this whole system is keep moving all the time with accurate precision and high degree of accuracy, with no accidents and no slim chance of accidents. That tell us that there must be a superpower that controls the movement of all these planets. If you read Psalm 19, David said, "The heaven declares the glory of God, and the firmament show his handiwork. Day unto day utter speech, and night unto night reveals knowledge." Which means, if you don't believe in God, but just look at the stars, look at the movement of the star, look at the routine, look at the control of moving the stars, you realize there is a God, a superpower God, that he controls all the movement of these stars. The ancient people believe in God, and that's very clear to us from their artifact. There was always belief in a godly power. For example, pharaohs in Egypt, they made monument which point to the heaven. As you see here, this big erection has a point end. They pointed to God in heaven. Other nations believe in more than one God for different conditions. God for war, God for peace, God for rain, God for protectivity, and so on. So proved God exists through astrology, the movement of the star, the movement of the planet, the accurate system of the galaxies. Now we talk about the science. The science actually proved God exists through many ways. And this is a good way for everyone who look for proof outside the Bible and outside the church. Science proved that nothing happened on its own or by random chance. Science proved that there is God who put rules and control and keep these rules. Among the many laws that we know now about inheritance is Mendelian inheritance law, where there are specific genetic rules. Now, for example, in this model, which has been taught in middle level school, that we can know if you have affected male with certain condition and a healthy female, what the chance that the sibling for first generation will be affected, and what the chance in the second and third generation as well. Now through science, we can even understand why certain family has terrible diseases that nobody can understand in the past. For example, King George III and his family, all of them, they had some condition of insanity, being called crazy. Now we understand is because of accumulation of porphyrin, a case called porphyria, that lead to abnormal deposition of the brain and insanity. Charles II, King of Spain, used to have this big looking ugly face. Now we understand it's due to overproduction of hormone called growth hormone. Hemophilia, which is known as X-linked disease in males, it actually through the daughter who spread to the royal boys. So the daughters are saved while the boys are affected and the boys die young. This was known as Victoria's Secret. When all this daughters are surviving while the sons die early. So now we understand there are rules. There are scientific rules that control the life on the earth, the life of the human. And if there are rules, there must be a God, a creator, who put these rules in place and maintain them and keep them. Nothing happened by random chance, as the atheists claim. Nothing happened its own, as the atheists claim. Most of the things happen according to rules, and God put these rules in place. Third, living creature. If you're looking at the living creature, you'll be impressed by the amount of diversity in the world. I show here a picture of birds. Look at them. They are one species, but completely look different. Different color, different look. Look at the fish. All these beautiful colors in one fish. That tell us that God not only a creator, but he is an artist creator. He add color, he add life, he add beauty to his creation. And every sort of creature has what needs to survive. The birds have wings, the fish have fins, the human have mind and feeling. Never see a bird with hands or fish with feet or human with wings. Everyone got only what he needs to survive in his own environment. Diverse of the environment too. It's not like one type of environment. Everything has a different taste. For example, the river have a sweet water for human. The ocean have salt water for fish. The life always change between day, light and dark, because people need to work in the day and rest in the dark. You cannot spend the whole time in darkness or you get depressed. You can be the whole day in light or people go crazy. So God makes this variation that suits humans to live and survive on the earth. Although there is diversity and beauty to every creature, but also there is unique feature to everyone. For example, if you're looking at every human, we have the unique fingerprint. With billions and billions of people who live in the earth, none of them have similar fingerprint. Everyone has own unique print. Now they discover something called the retinal print, which basically look to the fundus of the eye. You can see the distribution of blood vessels in the retina is also unique to every human. So that tells us, although I'm making diversity, but I make every one of those unique in one way or another. If you look into the fish, they have these beautiful colors and so many type of fish, so many different colors. Even if you look at one branch, there are so many different leaves on that branch. None of them is identical to the other. They have different shape, different number of striation, different direction. That tells us God doesn't just make a copy image of one another. God is an artisan. He create and he excel and he make beauty things. Beautiful things you can enjoy it. Complexity, human complexity. All the human organs are so complex. The brain, the heart, the kidneys, the liver, everything in the human is so complex. Among the things that really amazing is the brain. If you look at the human brain with your naked eye, it all looks the same. And if you examine it under the scope, again, it all looks the same. However, each one focus and each area has different function. So if you get one area's damage, you have certain form of deformity or injury that can be clinically manifested. Although morphologically they look the same, under the scope they look the same, but in terms of function, everyone has its unique function. Injury in one area may be lost, result in loss of memory, injury to another area might lose paralysis and so on. Number four, divine revelation. God declared himself to us. The atheists claim that no one has seen God and God never showed himself to us. That's absolutely wrong. When you read the Bible, there are so many occasions God revealed himself to us. For example, God spoke to Abraham many times. God spoke to Moses and handed him the Ten Commandments. We're all very familiar with the story of Elijah who have seen God. And we're all familiar with so many prophets of the Old Testament like Isaiah and Ezekiel who have seen God in his thrones. So God declared himself to us in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. As the Gospel of St. John, the word became man. The word means the logos became man. And St. Paul, in his opening statement in the Epistle to the Hebrews, God, who at various times and in various ways spoke in time, passed to the Father by the prophet, has in this last day spoken to us by his Son, whom he has appointed heir of all things, through whom also he had made the worlds, who being the brightness of his glory, the express image of his person. So God declared himself to us in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. Notice the first commandment that God gave to Moses, I am the Lord your God, you shall have no other gods before me. And this was mentioned twice, one in Exodus 20, another time in Deuteronomy 5. There are so many verses in the Bible about the presence of God and the uniqueness of God. I list some of them here. I am the Lord, and beside me there is no savior, Isaiah 43. I am the first, I am the last, beside me there is no God, Isaiah 44. I am the Lord, and there is no other, there is no God beside me, Isaiah 45. So I just picked some verses. You will notice they are coming from the book of Isaiah in a chapter that are following one another, 43, 44, and 45. God control the evil. The Ace is saying that if there is God, there should be no evil. And God had no authority over evil or the evildoer. Actually, that's not true. Because the Bible tells us many stories that God reward the righteous and punish the evildoer. Among the very famous story is the story of King Hezekiah, who was the king of Judea, and the army of Sanhedrin, the Assyrian king, surround the city and tried to come and destroy it. What did King Hezekiah do? He spread the message of threatening letter before God and prayed. The same night, God sent his angel and destroyed the entire army of Sanhedrin, 185,000 soldiers being killed at one night by one angel. Not only that, but the king himself went back to his home and being killed by his own son. There are many stories in the Bible tell us that God has power and control over evil and punish the evildoer. Among them, the very famous story of burning Sodom and Gomorrah and drowning a Pharaoh in the Red Sea. In the New Testament, Jesus showed his power over evil and over the devil himself many times. He cast out many demons in many different occasions. Some atheists claim there is no God because there are so many tornadoes and disasters happen in the world, and God has no control over the world. Actually, that's wrong. If you read the Bible, you see God has control over the world. He rewards the righteous people in a very significant way that cannot be unnoticed. For example, Father Abraham, God told him, I'm going to bless your seed like the stars of the sky and like the sand of the seashore. And you'll know now the descendant Father Abraham, including the Jewish, the Christian, and the Muslim. And nobody can count them. They represent the majority of people lived on the earth. God blessed Moses. And Moses lived and became a great figure in the history of the Jewish nation. So many people named after Moses, so many schools, so many churches, so many saints named after Moses. God blessed David and built him a kingdom. There are almost around 20 kings followed David. They all became his grandsons because God blessed David and his descendants. And so on with so many other saints. God blessed Moses when he crossed the Red Sea and showed power to him. God controlled the world, and that's very clear to us from many occasions and events in the Bible. For example, in the 10 plagues, we hear about the locust who God just sent a big storm of wind and bring locust. When Pharaoh showed repentance, God sent wind to the different direction and took away the locust from the land. We show that God have overcome the power of fire as he appeared with the three young men in the den of fire. And even over this, when he raised so many people from dead, and he himself rose from dead and gave his disciples the power to raise dead people, like what happened with St. Paul and St. Peter. Next one is biblical proof. There are so many biblical proof about God's existent authority over creation earth. I'm going to refer you here to the Genesis chapter 3, when God start to give punishment to the serpent. So the Lord God said to the serpent, because you have done this, you are cursed more than all the cattle and more than every beast on the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. Genesis 3, 14 and 15. From the time that God gave the punishment to the serpent till today, all the snakes in the world, they crawl in their belly. They don't have feet. And actually, some of the scientists start to study this, and they figure out that the gene responsible for the development of feet in the serpent, in the snake, are completely shut down. There is no gene to develop feet. And that's why all the snakes in the world crawl in their belly. So God's punishment, who gave it to the serpent in chapter 3, book of Genesis, exists and valuable and effective till today. Eve's punishment to the woman, he said, I will greatly multiply your sorrow and your conception. In pain you shall bring forth children, your desire shall be for your husband, and he shall rule over you. Till today, all the mother on the earth suffer during pregnancy and during labor. It's nothing easy. They come with pain. The same way God said to Eve, it go across all the women in the world. So God's punishment went across the entire human descendant. The same way it did with the serpent, now it happened with Eve. And to Adam, he said, because you have heeded the voice of your wife and have eaten from the tree of which I commanded you, you shall not eat of it. Cursed is the ground for your sake. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Both thorn and thistle it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the herb of the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken, for dust you are, and to dust you shall return. Until today, all the humans, when they die, they turn into dust. So now we understand that the punishment that God gave to Adam and to Eve, to the serpent, go through effect through the entire generation from the time Adam and Eve were created till today. That tells us not only God exists, but his word is so powerful. It goes through generation, millions and millions of years, and his word is powerful. Man toil in the sweat of his face, earn his living. Of course, we all know in the creed, yes, we believe in one God. Now I covered all the claims by the atheists. We're gonna address the claim by the youth. The youth claim that church put strict rules on us, want us to lead a short life, want us to focus on heaven and ignore the earthly fun or the earthly lust, push on us too many fasting, too many prayer, too many matanias. I want to tell you all these are put by the church for your benefit. All these are put by the church to make you understand that life on earth is so short. You're going to go by so fast. And you can't just waste your life on earthly lust. Or you're going to end up like the rich fool man who will start to thinking he's going to live for so many years. And God told him, in this night, your soul will be taken away from you. So the church doesn't want to get surprised by the time you're this, want to be prepared to meet Christ and to do good deeds in earth to make you worthy to join him in heaven. Then finally, you come to the conclusion, who deny God existent? There are two groups, the atheist and the people who deny God for their desire. The atheist, the Psalm 14 say about them, the fool has said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt, they have done abnormal works, there is none who does good. So basically, who deny the presence of God is a fool, because the most important piece of knowledge is not aware of it, the knowledge of God. Second, those who deny his existence for their own desire. To those, St. Paul wrote to the Romans, chapter 1, and even as they do not like to retain God in their knowledge, God gave them over to a debased mind to do the things which are not fitting. Romans 1:28. Now, there is an important question here we have to ask ourselves. What are the consequences of denying God? When the consequences are following, poor conscience, everything becomes subjective and nothing being confirmed. And based on that, human will go into so many sins because there is nothing there to stop them from making sense. That will lead to lying, cursing, insulting, sexual morality, nudity, gays and lesbian, transgender, drug addiction, and so on. And remember, this is exactly what happened in the time of Noah, when people start to deny God, the descendant of Cain, and they end up all drowning. And only those who believed in God, the descendant of faith, survived with Noah. Those who deny God will fall under God's punishment. The same way with Sodom and Gomorrah, it will happen again and again. Punishment being earth and punishment in eternity. Those who deny God during the time of Moses and worship the golden calf end up dying. 3,000 people died, those who worshiped the calf. Definitely denying God will lead to corruption of the moral values. You start seeing old lesbian getting married, gays getting married, people fall under addiction. Now you have to think about it. Who benefits from acknowledging God? Who benefit, God or human? Definitely not God. God have millions and millions of angels praising him day and night. But human will benefit from this. We will benefit from knowing God because we'll know him, we'll love him, we'll live with him, and we have a share in his kingdom. We're gonna have the enjoyment, the eternal enjoyment with him and the saint and the angels. So definitely we benefit from God. Denying God will not hurt God, it will hurt us. When on the other hand, acknowledging God in our life will benefit us and will not hurt God at all. Remember, God at all time accepts the sinner. And we have so many examples in the Bible from the woman with the Samaritan woman with 5 husbands and living with a strange man. Represent the woman who has so many sins. God still accepts her and use her to preach to others. I remember his last word, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may also be. John 14:3. So this topic, we covered so many proofs of God existent through astrology, science, studying living creature. God revealed himself to us in many occasions. God showed his power over evil. He showed that he controlled the world and so many biblical proof of God's existence. I think this will conclude our lecture. I would like to leave you with some memorization verses. I am the first and the last. Beside me, there is no God. Isaiah 44:6. The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. Psalm 14:1. I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you will also be. John 14:3. Thank you so much for your attendance. I see you next week, another lecture in the Dogo. And glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.